Well, good morning. Today is Saturday, October the 26th, 2002, and we are at the Evergreen Mortuary and Cemetery where Samuel Hughes, Hiram Stevens, and others of our family have been interred. This mortuary is at the corner of Fort Lowell and Oracle. As you enter in the front gate, we have Samuel Hughes. First major grave on the front row. And I know that Hiram Stevens is down this left side towards the front row as well. And as you go in this Fort Lowell entrance and you go down to the corner and you turn left at the very first corner, you come to a large grouping of Hughes and Knox and Corbett graves back there in the corner. Sam wanted to be the first headstone as you walk into the graveyard so that all of his friends could stop and see him as they were buried. This area is the Masonic section. He, of course, was a Mason, a very active Mason, and he has the prominent headstone in this section of the graveyard. And here is Grandpa Sam. From Sam Hughes, if you go kitty corner back towards the back corner, is Annie's grave. We will go back and see Annie in a second. But right here behind Sam is Maggie Treat and who else?
Frank.
Frank and Maggie. On the very next row back is Frank Treat.
Right here. Frank and Maggie.
And right next to Frank is Maggie. Margaret Treat.
That's our great grandparents, right? Because Sammy is our great great grandparent. So that's our great grandparents.
That's our great grandparents. Oh, and here's Tom Treat right here. Excellent.
He had died as a baby.
So crossing back over Kitty Corner, and back here, where all of our family is Annie Hughes. As we're coming from Annie's grave to the next block over across the street, back into the corner, here's one we have found that is Eben Thomas Knox and Florence Wheeler. Here's Corbett, James N. Corbett Sr., 1893, and Josephine R. Corbett. Here's W.J. Corbett, 1853, and Belle Corbett, 1865, for their birth dates. Good marking place is that huge mausoleum there, right back in behind that mausoleum. Here is Knox Corbett, 1861. Lizzie H. Corbett, right next door, 1865. Gooley Bell, William A. Bell, William Corbett, and Ruth Harold Cap Bell. Leonard N. Corbett, born April 19th, 1888, died August 24th, 1888. Colonel Thomas Hughes, born May 1st, 1843, an Indian fighter, a pioneer of Arizona, a maker of Arizona history. Thomas Hughes. Uena, I think it says Uena M. Hughes, beloved wife of Thomas Hughes, died August 24th, 1893. Lewis C. Hughes, governor of Arizona, 1893, governor, born May 15th, 1842, founder of the Arizona Daily Star. We have Josephina Hughes, founder of the WCTU in the state of Arizona, mother of Methodism here in Tucson, wife of Governor L.C. Hughes, it says on the side, mother of Gertrude, Josephine, and John. John T. Hughes, gone but his work lives, it says, born July 28, 1873. Then from here, right back in behind, there's another row of Corbetts. Hiram S. High Corbett, 1886. Ruth W. Corbett, 1897. Three sections over from Samuel, over to the left, across the drainage ditch, or across the ditch, is a Hazel M. Hughes. Now over here from Sam, we found John Hughes, August 13th, 1838. Right next is Sarah Jane, beloved wife of John. Frank S., Franz S., son of J. and S. J. Hughes, died 1893 at the age of 22. Here's Hiram. We found him. H. S. Stevens, died March 22nd, 1893, age 61. Gone, but not forgotten. And a tree trunk. They've carved a tree trunk with a vine growing up the side and the cross of Christ. And he is in relation to Sam. There's the entrance, and there is Sam, where all the family is. That's a great story.
Vince tells it better than I do. My name is Barbara Tanfillo, and the story is that my great-grandmother, who would have been Emanuela Hughes, died and was cremated. And since she was cremated, the cemetery wouldn't allow her to be buried here. So the relatives snuck in the middle of the night and buried her ashes next to Sam.
Oh, is that right? So right here.
Somewhere.
Here is Sam.
Yeah.
So right here next to Sam. Cliff?
Where Sam was buried.
Would you tell that again, please? I'm sorry. Rewind.
You and I are the best looking members of this family.
Right.
And the question arose that Sam and others may have been moved here from another cemetery.
All I know is that I've been told forever that Sam was the chairman of the board of directors that made this Mason Cemetery. This cemetery was made for the Masons. And he was a 32nd degree Mason. And so he said, I want the first pick of the plots. And he picked the number one plot right here by the entrance. So that when, and I'm quoting him, he says, so that when people come in to bury their family, they can say, hi, Uncle Sammy, he's coming to join you. So that one probably hasn't been moved. Don't know about any others. But I think this is where Sammy picked when he was alive and he was buried there. And it probably hasn't been moved.
All right. Thank you. Richard, tell me your story.
Well, the cemetery originally was in the Presidio. They moved it from the Presidio to Stone and Speedway. And that's where everyone was buried, way out of town. And as the town grew, it grew around there, they had to move it again. And they moved it from Stone and Speedway to here. Now it could be that Sam had selected this spot but was buried over there because he died before they had developed this. I don't know. But Sam has a very prominent place here, and this is a Mason part of the cemetery. So, but there was another cemetery. The bodies from that cemetery are moved over to this cemetery.
Excellent story.
I don't know the year.
Okay.